I have an enzyme in my saliva that can convert starch, a complex carbohydrate, into glucose, a simple sugar, and I'm gonna prove it. I'm Mr. W, the singing biology teacher. I'm the creator of learn-biology.com and the BioMania AP Bio app. Let's learn about enzymes. Enzymes are protein catalysts. That means that they speed up the rate of chemical reactions in living things. In your mouth, your salivary glands secrete saliva, and within saliva is the enzyme amylase. Enzymes are specific, and amylase's function is to take starch, a complex carbohydrate, a polysaccharide, and to break it down into smaller molecules that your cells can use. This is a bit of an oversimplification, but let's say that what amylase does is to convert starch into glucose, a polysaccharide into a monosaccharide. That glucose can then diffuse into your cells where it can power cellular respiration. You can test for the presence of monosaccharides like glucose by adding Benedict's indicator to a monosaccharide solution and then heating it. If you see a color change, that indicates the presence of a monosaccharide. I'm going to add my saliva to two test tubes. This one will be our control. It has nothing but saliva. This test tube has starch solution, and I'm going to add some saliva to that test tube too. Now I'm going to set the test tube with starch and saliva aside to give amylase a little bit of time to do its work. While we're waiting, let's test the test tube that just has saliva. I add Benedict's solution to it, you can see it's blue, and then I heat it, and you'll note that there's no color change. So we can conclude that saliva on its own doesn't have any simple sugar. It doesn't have any monosaccharide. Now let's test the starch solution, the one without saliva, to see if there's any glucose in that starch solution. We heat it up, and look, there's no color change. What's our conclusion? There's no monosaccharide, no simple sugar in starch. Here comes our common enemy.
Biology confusion.
Didn't I say that starch is composed of glucose monomers? I did, and it is. But in starch, all of those monomers are linked together by covalent bonds, and that makes starch a completely different chemical substance from glucose. That's why glucose tests positive for a monosaccharide, but starch doesn't. Starch isn't a monosaccharide, it's a polysaccharide. And now for the moment we've been waiting for. Let's test the test tube that has a mixture of starch and saliva. We add the Benedict's, it's blue. We heat it up, and look, there's a color change that indicates the presence of a monosaccharide. But where did that monosaccharide come from? We're about two-thirds through. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments. Also, please like this video and subscribe. Check out my tutorial about enzymes on learn-biology.com. The links are below. Enzymes are protein catalysts. They interact with one substrate. The substrate is simply what an enzyme interacts with. Enzymes are big proteins, and only part of the protein actually touches the substrate. That's called the active site. Amylase has an active site that can break the bonds in starch that connect the glucose monomers together. Remember, I'm simplifying the interaction between amylase and starch a little bit. As amylase does its work, the starch, which is the substrate, gets converted into glucose, which is the product. Is biology amazing or what? Now check out my song, Enzymes.
Enzymes.